My name's Holly Helbig. I am from Dublin, Ohio, and I'm a solo practitioner. I spend a majority of my practice at horse shows. So I work as the official horse show in Lexington, Kentucky at the horse park, as well as the World Equestrian Center in Wilmington, Ohio. In a competitive environment, Stablelab is extremely helpful to me at the horse competitions, especially with respiratory, cellulitis, suspecting any type of viruses that might be occurring at the event. It's kind of a first go-to for me. Anything that presents with a fever or anyone who comes to me that has a horse that might be coughing and we're not sure if it just got off the trailer, maybe there's shipping fever involved versus just environmental from the trailer ride. So it's a big tool that I use right out of the gate to kind of start make an assessment. I use Stablelab to manage an influenza outbreak back in 2019 that we had at a very large indoor facility. It was one of the first things that we used for people that wanted to just get a baseline on all the horses that were exposed. So the people that chose to have the horses screened, we obviously did a physical exam, but one of the other initial things that we used was the Stablelab, in which we ran it, and horses that were over 50 got put into an intermediate isolation and then were further tested for PCR. Horses that were under 50 were then, you know, put into another group, not as being flagged as potentially having influenza. I use Stablelab in our quarantine to help figure out when to run the PCR again. That was probably the biggest use of it. So what we started to find out was that it took a long time. These horses were shedding for a long time. We kept running a lot of PCRs that is very costly. So we started to realize that the SAA had to get down below really even 30, 40 before the horses started to become PCR negative. So we started to use SAAs more frequently to help figure out when to run the PCR to release them from the quarantine. We also use Stablelab or the SAA reader for the horses that had pneumonia, and we were just using it to monitor them in response to antibiotics and to monitor their outcome essentially.